家好，
我是 Sana，
我是 Warren。 今天要为您念的是练习手册第94课，我人是上主所创造的我。 Lesson 94， I am as God created me。 让我们先来唱吧。
我人是上主所创造的我， I am as God created me。 我人是上主所创造的我， I am as God created me。 今天我们要继续深入这个带给人全面救恩的观念。这一句话，主已应人间各种诱惑一蹶不振，这一念足以使小我晋升而彻底瓦解。Today, we continue with the one idea, which brings complete salvation, the one statement which makes all forms of temptation powerless, the one thought which renders the ego silent and entirely undone. 你就是上主所创造的你。 You are as God created you.世上所有的杂音顿时沉寂下来，世上的一切景象都烟消云散，世上的一切想法会被这个观念扫荡一清。 The sounds of this world are still, the sights of this world disappear, and all the thoughts that this world ever held are wiped away forever by this one idea.救恩就这样完成了。Here is salvation accomplished. 疯狂的绳子在此恢复了清明。Here is sanity restored. 真实的光明就是力量，力量就是清白无罪。True light is strength, and strength is sinlessness.只要你还是上主所创造的你，你必是坚强的，光明必然仍在你内。 If you remain as God created you, you must be strong, and light must be in you. 为你的清白无罪担保的那一位，必然也会保证你的力量与光明。Ensured your sinlessness must be the guarantee of strength and light as well. 你仍是上主所创造的你。 You are as God created you. 黑暗遮蔽不了上主之子的荣耀。 Darkness cannot obscure the glory of God's Son. 你立于光明之中，在你受造的清白无罪中气力不摇，你会这样活到永恒。 You stand in light, strong in the sinlessness in which you were created, and in which you will remain throughout eternity. 今天我们继续利用白天每一小时的最初五分钟，试着体会一下你的内在真相。Today, we will again devote the first 5 minutes of each waking hour to the attempt to feel the truth in you. 用下面的句子作为练习的开始。Begin these times of searching with these words. 我仍是上主所创造的我。 I am as God created me. 我永远都是他的圣子。I am his son eternally. 现在试着深入在你内的上主之子。 Now try to reach the son of God in you. 这个智性不曾犯罪，也不会妄照假象来取代实相。 This is the self that never sinned, nor made an image to replace reality.这个智性绝不会离开他在上主内的家园，彷徨地在人间流浪。 This is the self that's never left its home in God to walk the world uncertainly. 这个智性完全不知恐惧为何物，失落、痛苦或死亡对他是不可思议的事。This is the self that knows no fear, nor could conceive of loss or suffering or death. 若想达此目标，你只需放下所有的偶像及自我形象，不再理睬你加在自己身上那一串好好坏坏的特质，只是静静地等待你的真相来临。Nothing is required of you to reach this goal except to lay all idols and self-images aside. Go past the list of attributes, both good and bad, you have ascribed to yourself, and wait in silent expectancy for the truth. 上主亲自许诺了，他会将真理启示给所有祈求的人。God has himself promised that it will be revealed to all who ask for it. 你现在已经在求了。You are asking now. 你一定会得到的，因为上主从不食言。You cannot fail because he cannot fail.如果你无法在每小时之初都练习五分钟的话，至少每小时记得这样提醒自己。If you do not meet the requirement of practicing for the first 5 minutes, for every hour, at least remind yourself hourly. 我仍是上主所创造的我。I am as God created me.我永远都是他的圣子。 I am his son eternally. 今天随时提醒自己，你是上主所创造的你。 Tell yourself frequently today that you are as God created you. 一旦有人好似触怒了你，记得要以下面的句子去回应。 And be sure to respond to everyone who seems to irritate you with these words. 你仍是上主所创造的你。 You are as God created you. 你永远都是他的圣子。 You are his son eternally. 今天尽可能每小时定时的练习。 Make every effort to do the hourly exercises today. 你所做的每一个练习都是迈向解脱的一大步，也是学习本课程思想体系的一个里程碑。 Each one you do will be a giant stride toward your release and a milestone in learning the thought system which this course sets forth. 以下是真凶的释义。 You are blessed beings indeed.你确实是有福之人。 I am that one that you know as Jesus, and this is a very, very important lesson, and it is a wonderful, wonderful phrase to use within your mind anytime in the day that you feel that you have lost track of who you are. You feel inundated by fear or insecurityOr anxiety. 我是你所知的 JC， 这是非常非常重要的一课，且是你这一天当中可以随时在内心运用的一句完美的话。每当你忘记自己是谁，每当你感到自己被恐惧、不安或焦虑淹没时，你都可以运用这句话。You are as God created you, and any of the thoughts you have about yourself that are unloving make no difference. 你仍是上主所创造的你，你对自己所抱持的任何缺乏爱的想法对你没有任何影响。 Any of the thoughts that you have about another brother or sister that are unloving make no difference. They too are as God created them.
你对其他弟兄姐妹所保持的任何缺乏爱的想法，对他们没有任何影响。他们也仍是上主所创造的他们。
And so, you must see that you are not more powerful than God. In this case, you are as God created you. Your brothers and sisters are as God created them.
因此，你必须明白，在这件事情上，你并没有比上主更有权力。你仍是上主所创造的你，你的弟兄姐妹仍是上主所创造的他们。
Relax a while in this knowledge. Relax a while, knowing that all is well. You see, when you relax, when you stop running so fast and judging so harshly and fighting so hard, you realize that everything is all right.
请放宽心来接纳这一真知，请放宽你的心，心里明白一切安好。要知道，当你放宽心时，当你不再那么汲汲营营，不再那么严厉批判，不再奋力对抗时，你会发现一切都安好。
Everything is all right. You are all right. Your brothers and sisters.Are all right.
一切都安好，在这个当下，你安然无恙，你的弟兄姐妹安然无恙，世界安然无恙。
The world is all right for this moment, and so, in this moment, let go of everything that is not true, everything unloving, everything fearfully created by your distorted mind.
所以说，请在此刻放下所有虚妄的想法，所有缺乏爱的念头，以及你那扭曲的心灵，出于恐惧所造出的一切。
You are as God created you, and always will be, and have always been.
你仍是上主所创造的你，你将永远如此，且一向如此。
I am that one that you know as Jesus, and I will speak to you again tomorrow.
我是你所知的 JC, 我们明天再续。
让我们再来唱一次吧。
我仍是上主所创造的我。I am as God created me. 我仍是上主所创造的我。I am as God created me.
练习首册第94课，我仍是上主所创造的我。Lesson 94, I am as God created me. 奇迹正文第十章，疾病的偶像。Chapter 10, The Idols of Sickness. 第十章导言。Introduction.
没有任何大于你之物能使你害怕或让你更有爱心，因为没有一物大于你。
Nothing beyond yourself can make you fearful or loving, because nothing is beyond you.
时间与永恒都存于你心灵内，两者势必会冲突迭起，直到有朝一日你能够认出时间只是重获永恒的工具为止。
Time and eternity are both in your mind and will conflict until you perceive time solely as a means to regain eternity.
只要你还相信任何外在因素支配着你的人生经历，你是不可能认出上述事实的。
You cannot do this as long as you believe that anything happening to you is caused by factors outside yourself.
你必须学会看出时间完全操控在你手里，世上没有一物撤销得了你这一责任。
You must learn that time is solely at your disposal and that nothing in the world can take this responsibility from you. 你最多只能幻想自己能够违抗天律，却难逃天网恢恢。You can violate God's laws in your imagination, but you cannot escape from them. 天律原是为了保护你而设的，和你的永恒保障一样，凛然不可侵略。They were established for your protection and are as inviolate as your safety. 除了你以外，上主从未创造过其他东西，除了你之外，没有一物存在，因为你是他的一部分。God created nothing beside you and nothing beside your existence, for you are part of Him. 除了他以外，还有什么东西能够存在？ What except Him can exist?在他之外不可能发生任何事的，因为除了他以外没有一物存在。 Nothing beyond him can happen because nothing except him is real. 你的创造如你自身一样，只会为他增光添色，却增添不了任何与他相异之物，因为一切永恒如是。 Your creationsAdd to him as you do, but nothing is added that is different because everything has always been. 只有无常之物才会勾起你的烦恼不安。然而你是上主唯一的造化，它即使你创造为永恒的生命，无常岂有立足之地。What can upset you except the ephemeral, and how can the ephemeral be real if you are God's only creation and He created you eternal? 你所经验到的一切都是出自你的神圣的心灵。Your holy mind establishes everything that happens to you. 至于要如何与眼前万物互动，完全超之于你，因为你会如何看待他们，完全超之于你心中一念。 Every response you make to everything you perceive is up to you because your mind determines your perception of it.
上主从未改变过他对你的初衷，因为他对自己如此肯定。
God does not change his mind about you, for he is not uncertain of himself.
只要是他知道的事，人人均能知晓，因为这一真知不是仅仅为他而设的。
And what he knows can be known.Because he does not know it only for himself.
他是为了自己的缘故而创造你的，他还赐给你同一创造的能力，使你跟他一样。
He created you for himself, but he gave you the power to create for yourself so you would be like him.
为此之故，你的心灵神圣无比。
That is why your mind is holy.
有什么东西大于上主之爱？
Can anything exceed the love of God?
又有什么东西大于你的愿力？
Can anything then exceed your will?
世上没有一物撼动得了你分毫，因为你活在上主内，你的生命涵盖了一切。
Nothing can reach you from beyond it because, being in God, you encompass everything.
相信这一点，你才可能领悟到，原来有那么多事都操控在你自己手中。
Believe this, and you will realize how much is up to you.
当你内心的平安开始动摇时，不妨问一下自己，难道上主会改变他对我的初衷？
When anything threatens your peace of mind, ask yourself, has God changed his mind about me? 然后接受他的决定，同时拒绝改变你对自己的心态，因为他的决定千古不易。 Then accept his decision, for it is indeed changeless, and refuse to change your mind about yourself. 上主的旨意不可能跟你作对，否则他就是跟自己过不去。God will never decide against you, or he would be deciding against himself.
第一句，安居上主的旨意。What at home in God?
你并不知道自己所创造之物的真相，因为只要你的心仍是分裂的，就会跟自己的创造作对。然而，你是不可能攻击自己的创造的。You do not know your creations simply because you would decide against them as long as your mind is split, and to attack what you have created is impossible. 请记住，上主也同样不可能攻击他的造化。But remember that it is as impossible for God. 你应爱你的创造如同爱自己一般，因为他们是你的一部分，这是创造的法则。 The law of creation is that you love your creations as yourself because they are part of you. 所以凡是出自创造之物必然安全无比，因为它由上主天律，也就是上主之爱的保护。 Everything that was created is therefore perfectly safe because the laws of God protect it by his love. 你的心灵任何一部分若不知这一事实，等于自觉于真知之外，只因那一部分的你尚未具备真知的条件。 Any part of your mind that does not know this has banished itself from knowledge because it has not met its conditions. 除了你自己，谁能将你放逐？ Who could have done this but you? 你该庆幸自己终于认清了这一真相，只有这一认知才足以让你明白，你的放逐绝非上主之意，因此不可能真有这一回事。 Recognize this gladly, for in this recognition lies the realization that your banishment is not of God, and therefore does not exist. 你正安居于上主的家园，只是在做一个放逐之梦而已。你随时可以觉醒于真相的。 You are at home in God, dreaming of exile, but perfectly capable of awakening to reality. 这岂非只有你才能决定的事？ Is it your decision to do so?你的经验显示出你确实已把梦中一切当真了。You realize from your own experience that what you see in dreams you think is real while you are asleep. 你必须等到清醒之刻才会恍然大悟，梦中好似发生的事根本不曾发生过。Yet the instant you waken, you realize that everything that seemed to happen in the dream did not happen at all. 当你人在梦境，纵使梦里的情景完全违反你醒时世界的运作法则，你丝毫不以为怪。You do not think this strange.Even though all the laws of what you awaken to were violated while you slept. 有没有这种可能？你只是有一个梦转到另一个梦里，其实你从未真正清醒过。 Is it not possible that you merely shifted from one dream to another without really waking? 你岂会耗费心神去协调不同梦境里的矛盾情景，或者当你发现他们与现实不符，一并置之不理。 Would you bother to reconcile what happened in conflicting dreams? or would you dismiss both together if you discovered that reality is in accord with neither?
你已记不得清醒是怎么一回事了。
You do not remember being awake.
当你听到圣灵时，也许会觉得好受一些，因为那一刻你会重燃爱的希望，只是你仍记不得它本来就是如此。
When you hear the Holy Spirit, you may feel better because loving them seems possible to you, but you do not remember yet that it once was so.
你必须透过这个记忆才会知道它可能再度如此。
And it is in this remembering that you will know it can be so again.
你尚未达到那种可能的境界。
What is possible has not yet been accomplished.
但过去如此之物若是永恒的，现在必也是如此。
Yet what has once been is so now if it is eternal.
只要你能记住这一点，便不难知道自己所忆起之事即是永恒的，当下此刻必然也是如此。
When you remember, you will know that what you remember is eternal and therefore is now.
只要全心全意的渴望，你就会忆起一切真相，只因全心全意的渴望本身等于创造，因着这一愿心，便足以摆脱分裂状态，让你的心灵得以回归造物主与自己的创造所在之处。
You will remember everything the instant you desire it wholly, for if to desire wholly is to create, you will have willed away the separation, returning your mind.Simultaneously to your creator and your creations.
你一旦知道了两者的真相，自然不可能继续贪睡下去，一心只愿快快活活地醒着。
Knowing them, you will have no wish to sleep, but only the desire to waken and be glad.
梦境便无卷土重来的机会，因为你一心只要真相，当真相终于成了你一心之所愿，它就非你莫属了。
Dreams will be impossible because you will want only truth, and being at last your will, it will be yours.
奇迹正文第十章，疾病的偶像 Chapter 10 The Idols of Sickness 第十章导言Introduction 第十章第一节安居上主的家 What a holy God
愿大家有一个圣灵充满的一天阿们我爱你哟、哦